Hello YouTube, I'm Dr. Fox. Today, let's think about this question. Why it is important for my partner and me to share our family health histories with my healthcare professional. If anyone in your family has had health conditions known as genetic and developmental disorders, there is a chance that your baby will inherit that condition. An example of a genetic disorder is cystic fibrosis, and an example of a developmental disorder is autism. Just because you haven't had one of these diseases yourself doesn't mean you're not carrying the gene which causes it. So, if the healthcare professionals looking after you know about your family history, they can take the necessary steps to reduce risk to you and your baby. To put together a family health history, you should, ideally, have information about the last three generations on your mom's and your father's side. So, their parents and grandparents, aunts and uncles, nephews and nieces, and brothers and sisters. Doctors can put all this information together to give a picture of your family as a whole and see if there are any patterns that give clues about possible health problems. For example, they might notice that several people in the family have had heart disease or high blood pressure or a certain sort of cancer or diabetes. Some of these are not just caused by genes, but also by lifestyle and environment. For example, whether you smoke, whether you eat properly, and so on. Understanding how genetic disease is passed on is complicated, which is why you really have to consult your doctor about it. Remember, even if neither you nor your partner has a genetic disease, that doesn't mean your baby can't get it. Your baby will get one copy of every gene from you and one from her father. She will only inherit some diseases if both you and your father give her that gene. But it's important to realize that you and your baby's father can be carriers of a disease even if you don't have the disease. So, in some circumstances, you can pass it on to your children. Some ethnic and racial groups are more likely to carry genetic diseases than others, so that's another important element in your family health history. For example, if you are Black or of Black descent, you are more likely to be a carrier for sickle cell disease. And if you or your family have Eastern European Jewish origin, you are more likely to be a carrier of Tay-Sachs disease. If this sounds scary, remember that even if you have a relative who had a health condition, that doesn't mean that your baby will definitely get it. But giving your doctors all the information you can get will give them the best chance to decide whether you should have a test to check not only that your baby is healthy, but that you are too. For example, if it turns out some of the women in your family have had breast cancer, your doctor will tell you to start having mammographs done while you are still young. So, how do you actually get hold of all this information? The best way is just to talk to people and ask them if they have never had any health problems. You can do it face-to-face or online if that feels easier. If your grandparents are dead, you can find the cause of death on their death certificate or ask your parents. Once your doctor has had a good look at your family medical history, she may suggest you have a genetic test. Some doctors would recommend that all their expectant mothers have some tests, whatever their family history looks like. These include testing to make sure you are not a carrier for cystic fibrosis, spinal muscular atrophy, sickle cell disease, and thalassemia. If the results show that you are a carrier for these diseases, your partner will also be asked to have a carrier test. Also, your doctor may well suggest genetic testing if you have been trying to get pregnant for a long time but can't, if you have had two or more miscarriages. if you already have a child who have particular genetic conditions, or if you have already had a baby who died before her first birthday. Once you and your partner, if necessary, have had these tests, you have much better information about the chances that you could pass a disorder on to a future baby, which will let you really think about whether you want to go ahead with starting a family. Thank you for watching. See you soon.